So happy to be here. So happy to see beautiful faces. I must start with a disclaimer. You know, Mwakazi has been talking the whole morning with such a beautiful voice. So you can imagine moving from such a beautiful voice to now this voice. But I really appreciate that we took time, woke up very early, made it to Shamba Events for this very important conference. I'm also happy we are keeping time. You know, some time back in Britain, when they're having events, they would send two invitations, one for the British and one for the Africans. So for the British, would say 7 a.m. sharp, right? What do you think the Africans one would say? My friend from South Africa. 5 a.m. South Africa, 5 a.m. All right, so we've tried very well. And as I start, I want to recognize the presence of some of our guests and also appreciate all of us. All of us, we also guests to this event. Must appreciate Fadhili. You can wave. Fadhili is from all the way from Tanzania. We center Tanzania. We have Joshua. Joshua is from NetFund. We have our Miss Tourism. You can stand up in Africa, not Kenya. So, Budelenzi, you're sitting to me, next to Miss Tourism Africa. Strategic. We have our WE Center chairman, Dr. Tom Usili. And we have Stanley Kamanguya, who is the CEO of ICT Authority, who is also a very good friend of mine. We, in another life, there are things we also engage together. So happy to see you, my brother. All right. And also welcoming everybody. All of you look amazing. I'm happy how people show up. In fact, in the morning, I was asking the WE Center team. I was passing them. I was not recognizing them. The way they look so beautiful. Yeah. Can the WE Center team, the ones that are in the room, just maybe stand up and wave? You see how beautiful they are? So that is part of the team that has worked extremely hard to make sure, that we have a successful e-West conference, right? So why do we have this conference? Leon, technical team, you know, I wanted the online team to follow, so I don't know whether somebody is working on the microphone. It's so I use this one. Okay, good, excellent, sorry. So if you look at it, everybody in this room has e-waste somewhere. Who doesn't have any electronic waste? Please show us by raising up your hand. Who has disposed the electronic waste with WE Center? Show of hands. There's a hand behind there. Yeah. Only one person has. So the rest of us, where do we take our electronic waste? Where? In the drawers. Mwakazi, where is your e-waste? So the reason why we feel this conference is very important for all of us, one, is to create awareness about the monster we are dealing with. We are having a serious monster in the name of electronic waste. You know, other diseases like malaria and others, you can see symptoms. You say, this person, the way they look, maybe they are sick. They need to go to hospital. But e-waste is affecting us, but we do not know. Because it is slowly killing us. It is highly toxic. It is the fastest growing stream of waste globally. Why? Because of change in technology, because of the increased appetite for devices, and because of digitization. Right. Now, the problem is that this is waste that needs specialization when it comes to handling it. And that's why companies like WE Center have been trying to lead the way in e-waste management. So the first purpose for this conference is to create that awareness for people to know this thing is bad. Globally, we are producing 62 million metric tons of electronic waste. In kilograms, that should be 62 billion. Kenyans, we understand billions a lot. Eh? So let me use billions. So it's 62 billion kilograms of electronic waste that is produced every year. And you know what percentage of that is properly handled? Who can guess? Moreithi said one. It's true. So where does the rest end up? Yeah? So we have to look at it as a global problem. So it's not just a problem in Kenya. It's not just a problem in Uganda. And I know we have Ugandans. In fact, for this conference, the fourth edition, how many countries do we have represented? Joyce? Brenda? 68. So we have a representation of 68 countries who are attending this conference. Why are these people attending? It's because they understand why this is a problem. And we as Africans, we feel we have to be part of the people who provide solutions for the proper management of the e-waste. The other problem that we need to address is the lack of the systems. So once you get aware that e-waste is harmful and that you need to take care of it, what next? Where do you take it? You know? Do you have the policies in place? Do you have the regulations? And we realize this is a big problem, especially in the African continent. In developed markets, they have what we call extended producer responsibility, whereby the producer takes responsibility of end of life of the equipment, working in collaboration with government and also the private sector. These are policies that we need to adopt in Africa. And we do not want any African country to be left behind. We also need to get policies and laws that work for us. You know, you don't want to just copy-paste. And we have invited all these countries to also learn from them. So we want to learn from one another. And the reason why I am not making a speech is because the whole day today, this will be an engagement. We'll be discussing issues. We'll be discussing recommendations. At the end of it, we'll have a paper and say, on the fourth edition of the Africa International E-Waste Conference, these are the recommendations that we've made. If you look at the organizations that are involved in the E-Waste management in Africa, they are doing amazing work, but in isolation. So you have AU doing something amazing somewhere. You have the World Bank, you have the UN, and you have others who are doing amazing work. But how do we consolidate all these things and say, this is the direction that we want to go as a continent? So having the fourth edition is for us to just discuss these matters. This is the fourth. So We Center has been hosting three. The first one we started during COVID, which was virtual. Then we had the second one. We are having the fourth today. We will have the fifth coming next year. We believe by the time we are getting to maybe the seventh, we'll be having countries telling us we have benefited from some of the discussions that we had. In this room, we have representations from the private sector. We have representation from government, both national government and the county governments. We have representation from embassies, and we have representations from all stakeholders that need to engage to make sure we are moving in the right direction. So as we start this, I would encourage all of us to share the knowledge that you have, share the ideas, so that we build a beautiful continent. The 62 billion kilograms of e-waste that is currently being generated by 2030 will be at what? 74. Right? By 2050, it will be worse. And research is showing that by yesterday, 15th October 2024, we had an extra 56 million human beings joining us in this world. 56 million humans from all over, right? Meaning the population is growing very fast. By December, you can ask me that number. If you remember, I'll give you the number by December. But for now, we are at 56 million human beings that have joined the planet by October 15th, 2024. For the Earth to sustain that population that we have now, which, what is the world's population now? Eight point something, right? So for the Earth to sustain that population, we need one Earth, 1.8 Earths. So it means what we have is not enough. We need another 0.8 to sustain that population. By 2050, the Earth will not be able to sustain itself. And this is not my, I'm not a researcher. This is research that has been done. And the only way we'll make sure we sustain the Earth is through thinking circular economy and thinking sustainability and making sure we're managing waste safely. So this is a responsibility of everybody. It's not a responsibility of a few, right? So I invite you, let's discuss. I'm wishing you a good day. I know we've started late. We have a packed program. I think we are staying here until late. But Mwakazi will do a good job to make sure we recover the time that we've lost. Please feel free to interact with anybody. We consider all of us experts. Okay? So I'll be around. I don't want to take more time. I'll hand over back to the MC with the amazing voice.